Hi, I'm Aisha. You are watching Educational Hub. After you have identified a research problem for your project, the next step is to write a problem statement. An effective problem statement is concise and concrete. It should put the problem in context. What do we already know? Describe the precise issue that the research will address. What do we need to know? Show the relevance of the problem. Why do we need to know it? Set the objectives of the research. What will you do to find out? First, we need to understand the term. What is a problem statement? A problem statement is a concise description of the problem or issues a project seeks to address. The problem statement identifies the current state, the desired future state, and any gaps between the two. A problem statement is an important communication tool that can help ensure everyone working on a project knows what the problem they need to address is and why the project is important.
Now going to our main topic, how to write problem statement.
Step 1. Contextualize the problem. The problem statement should frame your research problem in its particular context and give some background on what is already known about it. Practical research problems. For practical research, focus on the concrete details of the situation. Where and when does the problem arise? Who does the problem affect? What attempts have been made to solve the problem? Theoretical research problems. For theoretical research, think about the scientific, social, geographical, and/or historical background. What is already known about the problem? Is the problem limited to a certain time period or geographical area? How has the problem been defined and debated in the scholarly literature? Step 2. Show why it matters. The problem statement should also address the relevance of the research. Why is it important that the problem is solved? This doesn't mean you have to do something groundbreaking or world-changing. It's more important that the problem is researchable, feasible, and clearly addresses a relevant issue in your field. Practical research problems. Practical research is directly relevant to a specific problem that affects an organization, institution, social group, or society more broadly. To make it clear why your research problem matters, you can ask yourself, what will happen if the problem is not solved? Who will feel the consequences? Does the problem have wider relevance? For example, are similar issues found in other contexts? Theoretical research problems. Sometimes theoretical issues have clear practical consequences, but sometimes their relevance is less immediately obvious. To identify why the problem matters, ask, how will resolving the problem advance understanding of the topic? What benefits will it have for future research? Does the problem have direct or indirect consequences for society?
Step 3. Set your aims and objectives. Finally, the problem statement should frame how you intend to address the problem. Your goal should not be to find a conclusive solution, but to seek out the reasons behind the problem and propose more effective approaches to tackling or understanding it. The aim is the overall purpose of your research. It is generally written in the infinitive form. The aim of this study is to determine. This project aims to explore. I aim to investigate. The objectives are the concrete steps you will take to achieve the aim. Qualitative methods will be used to identify. I will use surveys to collect. Using statistical analysis, the research will measure.
Use the following process to craft a problem statement that addresses the following. 1. Identify the problem. Before you can begin writing your problem statement, you first need to identify what the problem is. 2. Begin your statement with your ideal situation. Next, you can begin writing your problem statement by describing what the ideal environment would look like if your problem didn't exist. This section should try to describe what your company hopes to accomplish as a result of the process improvement project. 3. Describe current gaps. Next, write the reality section of your problem statement. Your goal in this section should be to clearly identify what the current environment looks like. In this section, you should identify what the problem is, what is causing the problem, and why it is an issue. You should also describe when, where, and how you were able to identify the problem. 4. State the consequences of the problem. Next, write the consequences section of your problem statement. This section is used to quantify and support the claim of what the problem is. You can use this section to identify specific numbers such as the amount of time or revenue being lost or the number of resources being wasted. It is important to include concrete numbers that support your claims in this section. 5. Propose addressing the problem. Finally, end your statement with a proposal section. In this section, you should try to identify how your company will make progress toward reaching your goals and accomplishing your ideal environment. Thank you for watching. I hope you can easily understand that how to write problem statement in research paper. Like, share, and subscribe my channel for more informative videos about research.